Well done. You played yourself. You really thought that you could get those two essays plus that worksheet completed in time for tomorrow after spending 3 hours on YouTube. We've been through this already. Unbelievable. What my mind tells me after I convince myself that that one video would be the last until I break away to do my work. Yet, I find myself tangled in this web, more loyal to the play button than the pile of books on my desk. You see, I have a problem. I tend to prolong things until the last minute, much like this speech, until that nauseating feeling rushes through my body like an alarm clock for leaving the workload freakishly too late. But sincerely, it's not my fault. What can I do when procrastinating be my favorite form of escape and escape be my favorite form of relief, and relief is something I can't flower because the stress is embedded in my roots? It most definitely stemmed from school. As soon as I jump into bed to do my homework, because it's the most comfortable place ever, it's as if the work's entire existence has completely disappeared as my consciousness just crumbles away like any second chance my mind would give me to awake again. Even when writing this very speech, I got distracted twice by the sound of cars whizzing past, and before I knew it, I was watching rom-coms, laughing until it was funny enough to cry, crying until it was sad enough to forget that I had an unprepared speech to perform the very next day. I feel like I'm walking on an ocean of timeliness that I can't baptize myself in. Oiled in the "I'll do it later" or "tomorrow" excuses. I can't be the only one going through this, though. Over 70% of students consistently procrastinate or have problems associated with this habit. But this can't go on any longer. One survey revealed that 94% of the people questioned said that procrastination hurt their happiness. It's clear that indulging in these hesitations creates devastations of our self-esteem. Insomnia, overeating, and depression are a few more of the mental health implications. Escalations of stress and frustration can leave us with a lack of motivation to get on with our education. And isn't this what we're working so hard for? Why we're even here? A set of good grades at the end of our GCSEs? Procrastination and other bad habits are practically lethal to our mental health, which can really weigh us down. So put your head first. Our mental health only really holds weight in schools for 7 years, but is asked to hold on to forever. So protect it. And no, you can't leave that for later. Thank you.